Get the job done. I know that as an athlete for me at Syracuse before I left Iowa, there was no one there that I could look at and say, okay, well, he's doing this. You know, that's what it takes. And I think Logan brings that. You know, Logan brings for everyone in that room, okay, here's what he's doing, and it's worked. So if I can at least do that, you know, my chances go up. So it takes away doubt, you know, and doubt's natural for us. You know, we all wonder. You know, so he's been, beside the fact that he's one of the hardest workers and lives an incredibly disciplined life, it's not like, you know, the best guy on our team is a hoodlum. You know, we got a guy that's rock solid, you know, that sticks to some basic things in his life and is a great example. So, yeah, I knew as a sophomore, this could happen. When he was a sophomore in high school.
What did you see?
I saw something I just hadn't seen before. You know, I coached for a long time. I was coaching for maybe 10, 12 years, and I watched him at the Ironman as a sophomore. It's like, my gosh, I mean, this kid is really special. Then he, as a junior, you see him again as a senior, and he committed as a sophomore. He almost was on the world team as a sophomore in high school, this kid. So you, in your mind, like, you know, like we do, you almost fantasize and you play it out. Like, if I get this guy and we put him in the right environment, oh my God, what can happen? You know, and now we're 5-6 years down the road and it's happening, you know. And he talked about the first one. In the first one, I went crazy. You know, I was absolutely out of my mind. And not only because it was the first one, I was happy for him, but because, you know, you can't be in this situation to get four if you don't get the first one. And I knew that would be his greatest test, because the kid was a returning champion. He's an elite, world-class level guy, and he got it. So the emotion of that night was we're in a position that 4 years from now we could be talking about a legend, you know, a guy that leaves the sport in an incredible with some incredible history. So it's amazing where he is, you know, and he's so humble, as you can see, about it all.
Hey, Tom, you were recruiting. Was there anything, do you remember, like, specifically telling him anything, trying to get him to come to Ohio State? Was it even much of a choice?
You know, he was at the national championships,
okay,
the year that Pacillo and Jaggers won it.
Okay.
So that was maybe my second or third year here. And there is great history here. Obviously, there's great history. It's a great wrestling state. And the timing, you know, sometimes the timing, you know, the timing was incredible. You know, we come in with a new staff, and Mike Pacillo, you know, follows me from Hofstra. Jay Jaggers was here, and this young kid, who's, despite the fact that he's crushing everybody in high school, he's a kid. He's from a small town, one-stop light town. He comes to the national championship, and he's in the bleachers, and he sees these two Buckeyes win a national tournament, and he's salivating. I'm going to do that. And I'm going to do that for Ohio State. And, you know, so, you know, I saw a guy that was just incredibly hungry, you know.
You said you saw something in him as a sophomore in high school that you hadn't seen before. What was it? What did you see?
Just his awareness, his timing, his, you know, he has, you know, he's like a ninja. You know, he's a ninja. I mean, he does things that you wouldn't think would work against a really high level, but the second, the timing that he does it at, it's a split second timing. You either, you know, you can do a move and it doesn't work. You can do the same move a half a second later, you know, or a half a second early, and it does work. Everything he does is like perfect, you know, when he's on the wrestling mat. Rarely, you know, his timing, a head lever, I mean, there's not a coach in the country that would say in the college level a head lever is going to work. Well, you know what? He makes it work. Because right when he takes you down, at the second his opponent posts his hand, at the millisecond, you have a split second. Once it hits, he's got his head where it has to be and his hair where it has to be. So it looks effortless. And it's incredibly difficult. I mean, it doesn't work if it's not, you know, at the right instant. And he just is always in the right place at the right time out there.
When we talked a few weeks ago, you mentioned that when you get a little older and you have some success,
yeah,
the challenges are different and they're new.
Sure.
Obviously, he's as accomplished as anybody's ever been here at Ohio State. What What is his challenge now in this final year? What's he going to have to deal with? What do you need to do as a coach to?
Yeah.
What do you both face, I guess, in this coming?
So you look for new challenges. Like I said, we already know that. Obviously, no other four times led his team to a title. Kyle Date didn't do it. Cale Sanderson didn't do it. Pat did it, but they'd won many. So only one of them, when he was on the team, won four. Won the team title. Being a hot trophy winner, it's something he hasn't done yet. I think for Logan, he came here as something, as one person, and he's the things that are important he's learned here. I mean, this guy learned the things that are important when he was young. I mean, he's like, as a fifth grader, a fourth grader, a third grader, this guy was entrenched by his family with things that matter. Family matters, love matters, patience matters, commitment matters, discipline matters, accountability matters. I mean, these are things that he's heard his entire life and has witnessed, by his parents, their marriage, just the way they do things. So we got somebody that was so entrenched that, I mean, we would have had to really mess him up, for. Now, you could have lost a 1-point match here and there in the national finals here in the split second, split second away. But the things that make Logan who he is, he learned long before he got here. And we just want to continue to bring those things out. We took him to, we took him to the, 6 o'clock in the morning, we got up before we left for our plane. And most of them weren't alive in 1995. They have no idea about the bombing, with Timothy McVeigh. So we took him for a tour. We had someone give him a whole tour of what happened and keep reminding them that this is, we're blessed. We're pretty blessed to be able to, so just try to make sure that we just keep instilling the things that he already knows.
Kind of add on to that, how do you approach coaching a kid that's like a ninja, so flawless and perfect on the mat? You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Like someone so many of those skills and
yeah.
Values already instilled in them. How do you approach doing that?
I think that you confront him with the reality that he hasn't won an Olympic gold medal yet. There's the standard out there. It's not like, every single shot he finishes. So despite the fact that he's dominant, the level he's at, there's another level. There's still a place to climb to. He doesn't need to be reminded of that, but at times we do. Just because you always tell your kid before he leaves the house to drive safe, don't text and drive. They should know it, but it's just a reminder. So he's got a really good foundation, and you just challenge him with being extraordinary. Pin your way through the Nationals next year, tech your way through the Nationals next year.
Aside from the fact that he was wrestling an exceptional competitor, what happened at Penn State? So
I think one thing that we all learn in this sport is the undertone of the sport is it's accountability. It's on you. Don't ever make excuses, because at the end of the day, you're the only one out there. Don't blame your coach. Don't blame anyone. But I mean, the truth is, he was at 50%. I mean, he wasn't even close to, not by. And then he wasn't doing. I mean, he was extremely sick. I mean, he was way less than 100%. And for me as a coach, I thought, listen, and it was a lesson for me too. Even Logan at 50% is going to be okay. But it took us, it took us 10 hours to get there in the bus. It was a snowstorm, should take 6. Didn't get to work out at night the way we thought we would. We got there late. You're wrestling a kid who's really tough, who's jacked up. There's 7,000 people going wild. And it was like, we call it the perfect storm. I mean, the perfect storm happened. And he was in the middle of it. So the official was hired because he was the closest guy to Pennsylvania, to Penn State College. I mean, because the official that we were going to have couldn't fly in because of the snowstorm. So, there's a lot of things you could look at. But the bottom line for me was, at the end of the day, what a blessing. What a blessing. There was a reason for all that. And I'm not saying he wouldn't have won it if he didn't lose, because he's so grounded. But it definitely, there's nothing like, we're all fueled by being the best version of ourselves. But with the doubters, can certainly add, you know, if you add a little bit extra flame that sometimes that you might need.
A little bit of inspiration.
A little bit of inspiration, you know. I mean, just, yep.
One thing about, you know, every wrestler goes out on a mat, puts himself out there, you know, they're out there alone and they get the toll on them. But when you're really going for history, you're even farther out there. Like Logan and I have talked about, you know, high reward, high risk.
Sure.
Not everybody's,
yeah.
I mean, not everybody's able to handle that. He's going for,
yeah,
you know, big yeah. time legacy history. Is there something about him that beyond his wrestling skills, his ninja, whatever,
yeah.
there's something about his personality that he wants to try to do that. He
yeah.
wants to take the risk that comes with trying to have a legacy instead of just winning matches.
Yeah, yeah. I think that, you know, this isn't answering the question directly yet, but several fell short on their third. They won their first, they won their second, the third one trumped them. The third one tripped them up. I mean, I have a couple of friends that lost in their third, like McGregor lost in their third, and you know, Ed Bannock went on to win an Olympic gold medal, lost in his third. So the third was tricky. To this point, no one has tripped up on their, the three were going for it, got it. So I don't know Pat Smith that well. I don't know. I know him because he's got a good little single. Thank you. But there's, and I know Lincoln who almost got four, and Tom Brands, and when they competed, there was just a calmness about them. Now I think for Logan, and I don't know, this is just my philosophy. I think there's an undertone of just simply happy in his own skin.
Mm-hmm.
He just has a lot of love in his life, and as monumental as the task is, it's simplified by his faith and the love that he has in his life. It just keeps it so he just focuses on that, you know, and he has complete control of his mind. He doesn't allow it to go to the what ifs and all the things that mine's going to go to. You know, that may not have complete control of it the way he does. You know, he just, you know, it's simple. You know, it's simple. It's stay low, attack the guy's legs, and keep scoring points.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's why I asked him about that.
Yeah.
You know, now you're going to be, he's going to be getting a lot of attention. He's going to get a lot of
right.
people like us
yeah.
asking questions.
Sure.
Who bring that what if into it. And that's going to be something that's he's going to have to deal with, right?
I think it's a great question. It's, you know, it's something that, you know, he's had some attention.
Right.
But nothing at this magnitude.
Right.
So, you know, maybe so few have been in this situation, and those that have something so unique about them that they can handle it, you know, or you wouldn't be in this situation to begin with,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I feel that, you know, look at who's returning. You have Rutherford back, you got 2 and 3 back, the number 2 guy's back, number 3 guy's back, number 4 guy's back. So there's some competition there. I mean, it isn't like, you know, this guy's going in and who wouldn't want to knock off the big dog? So you know, they could be a trivia question someday too. Hey, who stopped Sieber from his fourth? So, you know, these are people that are used to winning, and you know, I think we just got someone who's incredibly grounded here, you know. But we're going to learn too. You know, we're going to learn how he deals with it. You know, I think he's never been in a situation. You know, so as a staff, you know, and as someone who I think understands trying to be grounded, I think there'll be constant reminders.
He mentioned that he doesn't get nervous when he's performing.
Yeah.
He gets nervous for his brother. Is that kind of how it is for you when you're watching him? You're nervous. You're nervous for him. You're nervous for the other guys that are out there.
As a coach. I'm way more nervous. It's way harder to coach than it was to compete. You know, it's way harder to coach. Not only when they're wrestling, but, you know, you surrender. It's parenting. You surrender control. You know, and you just hope that the way you raised them and the way you taught them, when the critical decisions are to be made, that they make them. You know, it's tremendous. I mean, you know, these guys are like, I mean, he and Hunter are like, I mean, they're really, really tight, you know. He's got the older brother complex with Hunter, you know, but I mean, Hunter was there every step of the way this weekend. I mean, every warm-up. I mean, he was just loves him to death.
Hey, can you talk a little bit about the team next year? Obviously, Hunter's going to, you know, come back from a red shirt.
Yeah.
What do you, each different way, kind of what do you got? You got a couple kids coming in. Can you just explain a little bit about where you think you're going to be next year?
So 109 points won it this year.
109.
Penn State's going to lose about 55. And from my looking at who they have in the room, it's going to be tough to make that up at the weights that they need it made up at. 65 and 84 were phenoms, two of the best ever on the team together. So they got to make up. So let's say 110 win it. We have the potential to score 145, 150 points. The potential. And that's real. That's you know, now, you know, the unknown is you're talking about a freshman at 25 in Nathan, assuming Nathan takes Nick out of the lineup, knocks Nick out, Nick Roberts out. You got Nathan. You've got Bo Jordan, who's a redshirt freshman, and Nathan's a redshirt freshman, and you've got Kyle Snyder, who has a win over the reigning national champion to wait. So you're counting on some young people. Now, this year at the national tournament, two freshmen won it. They were no higher recruited than the ones that we have. Watching them in high school, I would have not thought that either one of them were any better than what we got. Were they as good? Maybe, but certainly not better. The guys that we have are grounded. So there's little concern for me going home at night that either one of them, I don't think either one of them either even understand what a bad decision is in life. I'm not saying never, but to this point in their life, you know, a reckless decision, I'm not sure it's in their DNA, the people that we have. So it gives you faith that, you know, now we're talking about certainly some luck, but they got to stay healthy and just live the way they've been living. So you got three freshmen that you're, I mean, they've got to perform. I mean, we've got to get 16 points a guy out of them, 12 to 16. That's not winning it. Logan scored about 28 this weekend with the way he pins and techs. So Kyle is certainly a potential finalist. Nathan Tomasello is certainly a potential finalist. Now, one and two are back. He doesn't need to be a finalist for us to win it. But that's his goal. That's my goal for him. Can he beat those guys? Yes. He beat Dylan Peters twice this summer by Tech Fall. He was in the semifinals. So, you know, it's not like this. We hope and a prayer. There's evidence. There's evidence through the successes these guys have had against the opponents that are doing well.
Your goals in that is
Big Ten and NCAA title for sure.
Okay.
You know, and you know, now, you know, is Logan, you know, walk on every day thinking about four? No, he's thinking about, let me get my run in, let me get my lift done, you know, let me get my nutrition right, let me get to bed early. So those are things we focus on, the pillars. But there's no question that it's the first time since I've been a head coach that we've got a group that can win a national championship. You know, and there's, we don't need we don't need something immaculate to happen. We just need people to be who they are. You know.